Stacey Sleeps Over is a really insightful series because I think it totally changes the dynamics when you're a house guest. It forces you to just get past the small talk very quickly. And you sometimes have to ask quite robust questions, but then a couple of hours later, you've got to sit down, you know, around the family dinner table and have spaghetti bolognese together. But it's not always comfy, I can't lie. It's not always comfortable.
But she's a child and yeah. You're the parent.
I've made mistakes. Messed up, do you know what I mean?
Series 3, we had a 70-year-old dominatrix who was a scream. She was such a good sport. We had a really lovely girl called Hanam. She's got a beard and, you know, she talks us through what it's like trying to sort of navigate her way through sort of day-to-day life. We had Gemma, who was such a sweetheart. She's got terminal cancer and she's also got 3 kids and this amazing husband and she's in her 20s. We also had a lady called Carla Bellucci, who is desperate for her and her child to be public facing. So very different conversations and very different households, but all interesting. There's never a dull moment with Sleeps Over.
Shall we? Oh my God.
I really loved Inside the Convent. Everyone was like, you're going to go and live in a convent with a load of nuns for nearly 2 weeks. I was like, yeah, now I'm really up for it. I just love hanging out with people that I wouldn't really knock about with day to day. And I love conversing with people that are so different to me. I've got to say, the nuns were so lovely. They were so, so kind. They were really generous. They were really honest with their answers. They surprised me. I came out feeling quite zen.
So how are you finding being kind of quiet?
It feels really strange to me.
Yeah.
Because I suppose when I'm around the table at home, chat.
I think stalking, I'm pleased that they decided to go ahead with the commission because I think sometimes when we're discussing this topic, we can almost be a bit flippant in terms of our language. Oh, you know, I've been stalking him on Insta, or God, I've been stalking on Facebook. You know, we sort of don't understand the severity of the crime. And also, you know, in many circumstances, it can lead to a fatality. So I think we really wanted to go in and sort of pick what stalking meant. But of course, you know, you're only human and you really feel for these individuals because their lives have been completely devastated, turned upside down, back to front.
He is everywhere I go, laughing and taunting me. I can't go down the end of the road because he's there. I can't go to work because he's there.
Two Daughters is a film that I feel immensely proud of, and I've got a really lovely relationship with Nina Smallman. So two of her daughters had been killed in a very malicious attack. I understood immediately, you know, the enormity of the responsibility that comes with trying to craft a documentary like that. So she's a perfect example of somebody putting their own trauma and heartbreak and devastation and grief to one side to try and sort of paint the bigger picture. Ultimately, she wanted to contribute to the conversation, violence against women. And I just wanted her to be able to say, in her words, how she felt the case had been handled. It's fair to say that the Met really and truly let Mina and her family down.
It's really important to me that we remember how they lived, not how they died.